described it. J.T. Ryle put it this way: nothing can altogether overthrow and destroy the church. Its members may be persecuted, oppressed, imprisoned, beaten, beheaded, burned, but the true church is never altogether extinguished. It rises again from its afflictions. It lives on through fire and water. When crushed in one land, it springs up another. The Pharaohs, the Herods, the Neros have labored in vain to put down this church. They slay their thousands, and then they pass away and go to their own place. The true church outlives them all and seeks to bury each in his turn. The church is an anvil that has broken many a hammer in this world and will break many a hammer still. The church is a bush which is often burning and yet is never consumed. We are a part of something that is literally unstoppable, eternally unstoppable. As we proclaim Jesus confidently, the powers of death will not stop the spread of the gospel, the building of Christ's church. Death cannot stop his Messiah, death cannot stop his messengers, and we know this because Christ gives authority to the church. So more debate and discussion about these things. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you mine on earth, you'll be bound in heaven. Whatever you lose on earth, you'll be losing them. So based on those verses, you've got all kinds of errant